So hello friends, and in this video we will be seeing Codeeforces educational round 85 and question number B, middle class. So first of all we will check what the question says. It clearly says that there n people lived, so we will be having n, and what this array of n will say is that the ith person in the array has AI birds. Birds, you can say number of money he has. And then the government considers a person wealthy if it has at least X birds. A person is considered wealthy if it has at least X birds. And to increase the number of wealthy people, or you can say to increase the number of birds which a person has, what we can actually do is we can make.
So for example, in this case we have 5, 1, 2, 1. So as if for a wealthy person, let's suppose x equal to 3. So now the number of wealthy person are only 1, which is 5. But actually if we take this and this, which is 5 plus 2 equal to 7, and then we will redistribute those birds, which means 7 upon 2, as we take only 2 people, so it will be 3.5. So now the birds will be 3.5, 1, 3.5 and 1, which means these are changed, which means these birds are redistributed among them. So now the number of wealthy people become 2, thus the wealthy people are becoming maximized. Thus we need to have that how many wealthy people we can have in final at last. So if t are the number of test cases, then 2t lines follows, and first line will have n and x. N is the number of array elements and x is the minimum amount which a person needs to be wealthy, and then we have n elements, or you can say the n birds. So our approach will be like this, that suppose if we have the birds, suppose 5, 1, 2, 1. So as we need to have the maximum wealthy persons, and also at the same time, we also want that the number of wealthy person we actually had in the initial should not get reduced. So we just need to increase the number of wealthy persons, and it should be considered that the number of wealthy persons are not getting reduced. So as we can see the constraints of this problem, we are clearly getting a hope that it may be possible if we sort it and do something. So we will sort it. So what we actually get is this. So if we start from the back and check that, let's suppose we take this, then if we redistribute among them, then what will happen? If we take these, then if we redistribute, then what will happen? If we take these and if we redistribute, then what will happen? Now why I do from the back? Because it is highest chance that it has highest money. It is only possible from the back that we can get the maximum wealth redistributed among those. So if we take 5, then 5 upon 1, which is 5, which is greater than x, which is 3. So it is right, means we have one wealthy person. So next we take 2. So 5 plus 2 upon 2, which is 7 upon 2, which is 3.5, which is also greater than 3. So now it is 2, because 1 also has increased. Now if we take 1, it means 5 plus 2 plus 1 upon 3, which is 8 upon 3, nearly upon 2 point something, which is less than 3. Thus we cannot take it. And similarly, if we add something more, which is less than or equal to this number, last number, then nothing will increase. So the maximum answer will be 2. Thus it is recommended that you move from last, and by moving from last you check what is the, by having this, if we can have the maximum wealth to be redistributed among them. Now, I guess you understand it. And now we will check how we write the code for it. So, first of all, we have T, number of test cases, Then we have NNX, we take N, NX. Then we have array elements, we have N array elements. Then we take the input of the array elements. We take a variable count. We take a variable count, which will count that how much wealthy persons we have up till now. Now we will sort it, because actually in the question I told you that we have to sort it. We have this number indicates, like initially I did 5 upon 1, then I did 5 plus 2 upon 2. So by this we will increase the denominator, and this sum will give the sum, as I did initially, I did 5, then after that I did 5 plus 2, so it will give that sum, 5 plus 2. And as I said, I will move from last, so I did move from last and up till the 0th element, or you can say the first element, which is at the 0th index to the array. I will do sum, so here sum initially is 0, here sum initially is 0, now the sum will become 5. Now I did sum divided by number, with number is 1, greater, if it is greater than equal to x, then we will do count plus plus, that is we have one element which we can take, which is wealthy, and after every iteration we will do a number plus plus, because actually after next loop it will do sum plus that number, and then we need 2, and if this sum become less, then we will break, because we have no further chance that we will get a number which will help us to make a person wealthy, and after that we will print the count. So it is the solution of this. I hope you guys got it. Thanks, and let's see. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me, even if it's